So now we will understand the homogeneous mixture and what are the properties of homogeneous mixture that make it different from the heterogeneous mixture. Now let's see. So as I have taken an example of sugar and water, what you see? It is a colorless solution. Plus, can you see any sugar particles in it? Can you figure out that these sugar particles is present here and here? Sugar particles have been disappeared. But can you recognize it? No. So, in homogeneous mixture, we cannot see the particles. The substances, once if you mix one component into another, we cannot see the components that we have dissolved. So in homogeneous mixture, particles that has been dissolved, or the substances or components, we should say the components that has been dissolved or that has been mixed cannot be seen through our naked eye. We cannot see through our naked eye. Now tell me, when you drink this sugar solution, can you find any difference in sweetness? Can you find any difference in sweetness in each layer of the water? Suppose I am taking a water from the upper layer. There is some sweetness. Now I am taking a water from the middle layer. And second, I will take a straw and drink a water from the bottom layer. Can you find any difference in the sweetness in the water? No. Whatever layer you take from the above, you take from the below, or you take from the middle. Suppose this is water and this is a mixture, and this mixture is contained of what? Sugar plus water. Whichever layer you drink or not, you drink from here, you drink from here, or you drink at the bottom of the container, you won't find any difference in the sweetness. In each layer, you will find the it has same sweetness. It has same sweetness. The sweetness that you found in the upper layer, it is similar to the middle and similar to the bottom. Since you can't find any difference in the sweetness, there is no variation in the sweetness. The sweetness is equally distributed throughout the solution. So we can say that in homogeneous mixture, the components get mixed uniformly. So we can say in homogeneous mixture, the components are distributed uniformly. Uniformly in homogeneous mixture. Because as I told you, similarly you take salt water. You won't find any variation of the saltiness. You will find that the taste of the salt you will find in each layer. The saltiness is distributed it has been distributed equally throughout the solution, throughout the water. You will find the same thing in here. You can find the same taste over here. You can find the same salt taste over here. You can't find any difference. So the mixture in which the components are equally distributed, or we can say the components are equally distributed throughout the mixture, we call it a homogeneous mixture. So this is a major property of the homogeneous mixture, that the components that have been added, that has been mixed to another component, these components get equally distributed. The components in which Thus, mixture in which the components are equally distributed or uniformly distributed, we called it as what? We called it as a homogeneous mixture. So this is the property. The first property is that the components that we are adding, that we are dissolving in another components, we cannot see that component. The particles of the components cannot be seen throughout the naked eyes. And another major property is that the in homogeneous mixture the components are equally distributed, are uniformly distributed, as you have seen in the sugar. You won't sugar plus water. You won't find any difference or any variation in the sweetness. You will find that sweetness has been equally distributed throughout the water. Sweetness has been distributed equally throughout the water. Now let's understand about the heterogeneous mixture. That what is now heterogeneous mixture? If this is the property of the homogeneous mixture, then what is the property of the homogeneous? Yes, one more property of the homogeneous mixture is that after making a salt solution or a salt plus water mixture, the particles, the salt, does this get settled down? Suppose you have made a solution mixture, you have made a mixture, that salt plus water mixture, and you kept for a 1 hour, 2 hour. After 1 hour, 2 hour, can you see any sugar particles getting settled down, or any sugar particles that has been disappeared at the beginning and it is started appearing? No. So in homogeneous mixture, the particles, one more property of the homogeneous mixture is that the particles does not get settled down. So one more property is what? The one more property is that it is uniformly, components in mixture do not settle down. How long you kept or not? You keeping for 2 hours, 3 hours, even after the 3 hours also, the sugar that has been disappeared at the beginning, that has been dissolved, as you have seen in the beginning, it does not started appearing after 3 hours. So in homogeneous mixture, one more major property is that the components in mixture does not settle down. Or we can say, or another way we can say, that it does not started appearing in the water. So components So these are the properties. Now let's come to the heterogeneous mixture. And we will understand the properties, that what are the different property, what property that makes it different from the homogeneous mixture. Now let's understand the properties of heterogeneous mixture. What is heterogeneous mixture? Remember, in homogeneous mixture I have told you the components are, in a homogeneous mixture the components are equally distributed, are uniformly distributed. Example, the sugar and water. You will find the sweetness, the sweetness of the sugar in all layer of the water. Throughout the solution, you will find the equal sweetness. The sweetness has been distributed equally. But in heterogeneous, it is opposite. Since it is opposite, so that is the reason it is different from the homogeneous mixture. In homogeneous, the components are equally distributed. Sweetness is being distributed throughout the solution, throughout the water. But here, the mixture that we will form, that it, the components are not uniformly distributed. So in heterogeneous mixture, the components that have been added are not uniformly or equally distributed. Just take an example of chalk and chalk and water that I have given in the last chapter. Example of soluble and insoluble, and I have taken chalk and water. What you have seen? The chalk is not dissolving in water and it is getting settled down. So we can, in that, we have added a component. We have added a chalk and the water, two different components, and we have mixed the two different components. And in that we have seen the chalk is sinking. It is getting settled down. So it is not uniformly distributed. Had it been in uniformly distributed, we could have seen the chalk particles or a chalk powder throughout the solution. We could have seen the white component throughout the solution, but throughout the water. But have we seen it? No, we haven't seen. We have seen the chalk has been settled down here. So this kind of mixture, the chalk plus water, sand plus water, that the things that I have seen. See, you can see that water, that here the sand has been distributed. See, can you see here? Here you can see the sand is getting settled down. The more here in the below, the more sand particle is present, but in the above layer there is no, it is less amount of sand is present. So here it is not equally distributed, like sugar plus water. It has been distributed equally, but here it is not. So this is heterogeneous mixture. Now it comes to the second point, that can we see the particles of components that have been mixed? Can we see that particle of the components or the components that we have mixed? Can we see that? Some we can see, some we cannot. Let's just see. Can you see here any particle? But you can see something is mixed in water, but we cannot see the particle. Similar, but in chalk powder, take the example of a chalk plus water. You can see the chalk, white color particles, white color component. So in heterogeneous mixture, some mixture we can see the component and some mixture we cannot see. So we can say we can see in some mixture we can see, and in another some we cannot see, or in some mixture we cannot see. An example is sand plus water, and for the mixture that where we can see the component is chalk plus water. Another example where we cannot see is milk plus water. Another example is milk is water. Now you are getting confused that how can the milk be heterogeneous? Yes, milk is heterogeneous mixture because the milk contains what? Milk contains fat plus protein. Since it contains, and this fat and protein are not equally distributed. You will see if you settle down, if you kept it for a long time, you will see that fat, that oily part is present at the above, at the surface of the milk. So see, the fat is present at the surface and the protein is present at the below. So since here also the fat and the protein, these two are different components, even these two are different components, they are not uniformly or equally distributed throughout the milk. So since it has not been distributed, so we can say the milk is a heterogeneous mixture and we cannot see the fat and the protein. Now let's come to the I have told you that in homogeneous, the particles, if you kept for a long time, even how much long you kept or not, the particles does not settle. The particles of the component that we have mixed does not settle. But what about heterogeneous? Heterogeneous is that it can be settled. The particles which we can see, they get settled down, as we have seen in a chalk powder. It getting settled down, it is getting settled out, it was present at the bottom of the layer. So here we can say some mixture particles or the components settle down. It's better to say component settle down. But in some, as you can see, milk, how long you kept or not, but they do not settle. Have you ever seen the milk getting settled down? Even if you keep it in a fridge also, you cannot see the separate layer. You can't distinguish whether it is a flat or it is protein. So here you can see that in some mixture, the components do not settle down. Now here also, you can see variation in the property. That in heterogeneous, some is we can see, we cannot see. And in some, we can say the components settle down. And in another, we can say in heterogeneous mixture, in another, we can say that it doesn't settle down. Example of is this milk. An example of this is chalk plus water. Now here, variation, two different property. Here, this is another property. This is again different property under heterogeneous mixture. Here also it is again classified. It has been classified into two ways. There are two different type of heterogeneous mixture. There are two different type of heterogeneous mixture due to the variation of properties. Two different properties, as we can say. One is that this one, other one is that one. And what are they? If we can see in some mixture, if we can see the components or the particles of components, or if the components get settled down, like sand plus water, chalk plus water, these components, this kind of heterogeneous mixture are called what? Suspension. And if in some mixture where we cannot see the components, and the mixture of the components does not settle down, they are suspended, or we can say they are suspended, we call them what? There we call them colloid. Milk colloid, colloidal solution, colloid mixture. So this is a type of heterogeneous mixture. One is called suspension, one is called colloid mixture. Because they have these two, under heterogeneous mixture, we find two different properties. So today, it is up to this. In next class, we will discuss about this, what is suspension, what is colloid, and we will discuss the separation that we need to do to separate this mixture. Thank you.